Hello there, this is David from Team Lawless, and welcome to this Black Ops Nightmare stream. And we are going to continue this stream today from where we were last time. So as we wait for it to load up, we are just going to quickly share it on social media, on Facebook. So I'm going to quickly go and do that. You gotta resume story.
Can you hear me? Are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm back. I'm ready to continue.
Good. Now that you've begun conditioning, let's return to 2070. After coalescence collapsed. You were trapped in Singapore.
With quarantine zones unlocked all over the world, we couldn't raise WA Command. If we were gonna escape, we had to improvise. We turned to the 54 Immortals. They were dangerous and unpredictable, but they were no enemy of ours.
Hendrix trusted them?
What choice did we have? If we wanted out of Singapore, we had to go through the biodomes. We had to go through the Immortals.
Wow, here we go then. Is this gonna start straight away, or no, more story mode? It's fine. Oh no,
we had a robot squad in place ready if the situation took a turn. Gojulan bolted before our robots got her. She was headed for the server room in Cloud Mountain, the only place we could put in a call from transport. It became quickly apparent that uninvited guests had joined the party in the biodomes. The dead were flooding into this safe haven. It was about to become hell on Earth.
Yeah, it's already hell on Earth.
We had to move. We had to get to Cloud Mountain.
Seriously, like, some of these maps would be fucking amazing. Damn. Really want a machine gun now. Die, bitches! Shit, I'm trapped. Damn. Freaking killing anything it moves. Let's see ammo. I don't want ammo, man. What's up here, man? That's an instant kill.
I don't know how the undead got in. A forgotten open gate. A child's mistake. A poorly nailed board over a window. It didn't matter. It was spreading fast.
Ah, yes, sweet, the magic box.
We were already outnumbered 20-1. The remaining humans scrambling away or locked in their homes.
It's an okay gun, but not good enough for what I want right now. See what the magic box gives us. Oh my god.
Yeah!
There we go, sight decent. Oh. Decent-ish. Right, let's go, let's move. Fucking Walking Dead. Previously on The Walking Dead. Fuck me, they're everywhere! Fuck you. Keep moving, man. There we go, man. Better gun.
I heard that familiar screech. Parasites, mutated creatures born out of 6115 were flying towards us.
Oh, great, they fly as well, man. Well, it was a safe haven. Fuck you! Fucking everywhere, isn't they? Guns get better, ain't they? Ramp.
With the shipping yard clear, Cloud Mountain was just ahead. The server room at the top. We had a long climb ahead of us.
What the hell is that thing? And it's red. Jesus, I don't want to die anytime soon, does it? Sweet. Was a safe haven. It ain't no more. Keep running, I guess. Well, I'm dead. Fucking shit gun, man. Fucking sniper come from? That's better. What's that? Oh my god, it wouldn't let me turn, man. Damn. Piss off. Fuck you, flying ones. Bubble off. Well, I ain't going in there anytime soon. Get away from me! How about the ones that are behind us, you fucking idiot? I love the way I'm up here on my bloody own. Now where? Are we there? I guess we're there, man. There we go.
In the server room.
By the time we got there, Gojulan encrypted her hardware, locking us out of the central server. Hendrix stepped in, but we were a few seconds too late. Damage was done.
Why did she lock you out?
It didn't make any sense. Sure, we weren't on the best of terms, but this wasn't her. Something else made her do it. Something was controlling her. The encryption used a biometric hand scan. Hendrix tried to unlock it. But the Go siblings were smart. They'd set up an access system requiring both of their hands for authorization. And her brother was shredded with bullets back in the bar. We could hear the Horde coming, and we only had one sibling. But she did have two hands.
You chose to cut off her hand. Why?
I hoped the biometrics were interchangeable, allowing the siblings to use either reader. If we were calling transport and getting out alive, it had to work.
And it did for us.
It did. Hendrix interfaced with the system. He was able to raise WA command. We needed a ride out ASAP. They had a VTOL a few minutes out. Rendezvous was set for the top of the dome. But Hendrix wanted to know what Gojulan had on Taylor. Anything, even the smallest detail, could be helpful in picking up his trail. That would take some time. And time was something we didn't have. Hendrix searched the archives. I dealt with the incoming Horde.
Oh yeah, great, brilliant. I have to deal with that. All that noise just to die. Okay, this is not as bad as I thought it would be. Oh, okay. Yeah, now this is where the gun takes about fucking 3 hours to reload. I have no idea what that does, but... Are you not in the system yet? Come on! Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, you piece of crap with a gun.
Hendrix had pulled all the data he could. I hoped it was enough. Our pickup was in position. It's time to get the hell out of here. Our bird wasn't alone in the sky. Our VTOL had caught the attention of an old automated race. We needed to find another way.
Oh, great! Just to get out of here. Brilliant.
This Wraith telling you. It was like the malfunctioning robot you found in different quarantine zones. The kind targeting anything and everything as an enemy.
Just like that. Except on a much larger, more deadly scale. And this one was very interested in us. Command had an exit route. Extraction set beyond the swamps. If we crossed the super trees, there were shipping docks where we could commandeer an airboat. It's easier said than done. Between the flesh-eaters and that wraith eyeing us, the super trees would be no walk in the park. We had to haul ass and stay out of sight. But they weren't our only concern. Winslow Accord picked up chatter ahead. Apparently, we might be only humans using the docks to escape.
What a ton of reload, you piece of shit. Where the hell am I going? I guess I'm going this way. Yes, I don't know. And go for that.
Super tree was collapsing. The only safe route to the docks was up. Chatter could see the 54 immortals were scrambling to get out of the biodomes through the swamps.
Yeah, super tree my ass. Should be deaf.
From the sound of it, they wanted us dead as much as the flesh eaters did. Looked like we were jumping from one bad situation into another.
Wow. Really do need another gun. Huh. I thought it was one of mine. I guess not. No, that's a shit gun. What you got? That'll do. Board the airboat.
Hendrix commandeered an airboat and set the autopilot. We had undead on our ass and more 54i ahead. And that rogue wraith wasn't done with us yet.
Fuck me, they're everywhere, man. Thank you. Aw, look at the pretty Ferris wheel. Bye, Ferris wheel. Product, where are we going?
Our exfil was just ahead. We were getting out of Sinner.
What about Taylor? What did Hendrix learn from the server?
Nothing. He did them white. Taylor was in the wind. And the virus. 6115. Wouldn't stop this time. The Winslow Accord and CDP had been thrown into chaos. We'd lost Hong Kong, Berlin, and Cairo, and it was just getting started. What would come next? How the world would change? There was no way to be ready for that.
The end of the world, I guess.
5 years. 5 long, dark years. Opening the quarantine zones did exactly as we feared. And by 2075, what was a contained situation gave way to anarchy. Humanity's numbers had been reduced to a few hundred mil scattered across the globe. The undead had risen to 7 billion. Taylor was in the wind. A faded reminder of our inability to stop Armageddon. There was still a Winslow Accord kill-on-site ordinance in place, but he was a distant memory, until the aquifers. We were on a routine bombing run outside Cairo. Our orders were to bomb the dead into the next life.
Well, here we go, next section of the,
Our target was a Catardus colony. They'd taken over a refinery. It was a well-armed facility protecting them from the dead they worshipped. Top priority was to cut off their comms and leave them in the dark. But first, we had to clear out their defenses.
Okay. Die, bitch! Don't think so!
This was a routine sweep. Every time another sympathizer colony sprouted up, we'd squash it back down. As far as we were concerned, we were doing the world a favor.
I destroy as much as I possibly can. Die, bitches! Like, you think the place would blow up, wouldn't you? But it doesn't. Here we go.
We moved on the array, but the undead sympathizers weren't going down without a fight.
Teddy bear! I want the teddy bears.
Our support detail needed a few moments to disable the array. Lucky for me, I had more hostiles to keep me occupied. Disabling the comms would take some time. Our support detail dealt with that. I dealt with reinforcements.
That's better. -38%. -40%. -50%. The fuck was that? When you're at home.
The station disabled. We had to get back to our bird.
Yeah, I'm fucking out of here, mate. Fuck you. Okay. Hiya. Welcome to Stream Vines.
The array was ahead. Bring it down. We'd be one step closer to eradicating this colony.
Yeah, man, we'll fucking die again. I can see this happening. We're gonna be going up. Die, bitch! Go for it. Alright, 8%, 10%. Here we go, man. We can do this. We prefer to be in the sky. grab an ammo box on the way out of here. Coming up to 70%, man.
With the comms disabled, we needed to get back in the air.
Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. Fully reloaded, ready to go. Here we go. Going in, I guess.
With their comms jammed, the next step was to breach the control room to take back the facility. There was access ahead. I just needed to get through the flooded room in front of me. Our support detail insisted on coming with.
When you were swimming, something went wrong.
Our D&I. There was a malfunction.
What did you see?
I saw. I was drowning. I thought I heard.
This is not your time. Get back up. Do not trust him. Everything is not what it seems.
What did you hear?
Nothing. I couldn't make it out.
Get up.
And I woke up. Someone pulled me out of the water. Someone saved me.
Saved you?
A guardian angel. Someone watching over me. My support detail. She got through somehow and pulled me out. She brought me back from the brink. She said it wasn't my time. My work wasn't done. I had to stop Taylor. I don't know how she knew. It didn't make any sense.
Did you know her? This woman?
No. I'd never worked with her before today.
And yet she knew about Taylor. She knew about what happened. And you're sure she was there?
What? Why? You think I made her up?
You yourself said your D&I systems were malfunctioning.
What? You gonna tell me I'm crazy next? I know what I saw. I did not make her up. I didn't fucking imagine her.
Did she have a name?
Of course she had a fucking name. The Guardian Angel. She said her name was Kane. She told me she'd help me through this. She said we had to move. Control was beyond a server room ahead. If we were going to take the refinery from these dead sympathizers, we needed to clear it out. If we couldn't, we would be on to Plan B.
Plan B?
Plan bomb this shithole to hell.
Wow.
We prepped to breach, but it turns out our enemies planned ahead. The explosion blocked our path. We had to double back. It caught us off guard. But the noise also caught the undead's attention.
Fuck off.
We regrouped with our allies. That's Egyptian Army Lieutenant Ziad Khalil, friend of ours. He was durable, seasoned. He defended his home through undead wars. He wouldn't go down without a fight.
What was the plan?
Khalil would move on control from the exterior. I'd sweep the dead from the air. Our guardian angel accompanied me. She told me the answer to finding Taylor was on this refinery. Why she thought that? How she knew that? It was so real.
Good night. Die, bitches! Die!
When Khalil took the control room, he found something on the security footage. Something we needed to see.
Taylor.
Like seeing a ghost. We just stumbled upon him. This wasn't just a Cotardus colony. This was Taylor's hideout. They were already evacuating Taylor. We locked down the facility separating Taylor and his associate, Moretti.
Who did you go after?
It was too late for Taylor. The Cotardus put him on a VTOL. We'd go after Moretti. Command informed us the kill order was still active. Hendricks didn't like that, but it wasn't his call.
How did you feel about it?
5 years. 5 years after our fuck-up, and he could fix it. I'd gladly take the shot.
Fuck this, I'm out of this. Oh, fucking Wild War 3 in here. Oh, we're moving now, are we? Go. Sweet. Fucking die. Yeah. Fuck off. Whoa. What the fuck killed me then? Are you for real, man? Fuck off. I need a ban. I sell for cheap. Okay. Moving. Moving forwards again. Ah, you fucking Wankstein! Fuck off. Piss off, bugs. Where's the bugs? Where's the bugs? They sell for 250. What are you actually going on about?
Moretti was just below us. If we were gonna get him, we'd need to take a shortcut.
Shortcut?
A leap of faith.
Ah, crap. Leap of faith. I have no ammo. I have no ammo. Not good. I need to find an ammo box. I need an ammo box. Right, you asshole, shoot that. I need the ammo box. It's just through here. Fuck for that. Fuck you. Oh, right, you had ammo. Moving on. Piss off. Banned for your YouTube channel. What the fuck? Oh, a banner. I'm with it. Right. I have one. I don't. Back to Walking Dead. Walking Dead. There we go. Reload. Excuse me.
Listen to her.
Trust. System's failing again.
Fine, Taylor.
fuck me, just keep running on that. Run, run, run like the wind! Fuck the magic rocks.
How was
here we go.
Coping with the change of plans?
He was upset. And why wouldn't he be? Command wanted our friends dead. He wanted to bring Moretti in alive.
But that wasn't all, was it?
No. Hendrix had been different since Singapore.
In what way?
Every way. Aggressive, angry. He was losing perspective. And there... something's just off. I should have known what happened.
How could you have known? Even if you had, what could you have done? You seem so certain of his intentions.
We all battle inner demons and our choices. Hendrix, Taylor. That whole team rose the ranks together, fought alongside each other. Little did we know one of his friends was watching us. Moretti had locked himself in the security room. Only way in was to cut the power. To do that, we had to overload the generators.
Ow. Die! Oh my god, some of these maps would be amazing, like I said, for Black Ops. Not looking too good.
You cornered him. What did Moretti say?
He said that name, same as Diaz. Deimos. He said if I wanted answers, I had to find Damian Bishop, a man we both knew from a past mission. Bishop could help stop Deimos. But first, I had to kill him. He kept saying, this isn't me, this isn't me. He kept saying Deimos made him do it. So I granted his last request. Killed him as he asked. I did our job. It didn't sit with Hendrix.
Can you blame him for his outburst?
Hendrix was pissed because Moretti was our link to finding Taylor. A link I just severed and split open on a spike. And the guilt I carried all those years that I channeled inward, Hendrix channeled outward. At me. This was our chance to fix our mistake, and I fucked that up. Hendrix said I may as well have damned the world myself. I'd had enough. I knocked some sense into him. Sometimes it was the only way to get through. I told him what Moretti had told me about Bishop, Deimos, whoever the hell he was. The mention of Bishop got Hendrix's attention. Last we saw him was back in 65, 10 years ago in Ethiopia. How Bishop knew Deimos, we hadn't a clue. But we'd figure this shit out, and we'd do it together. But right then, we had bigger problems. The Egyptian army couldn't hold the refinery. Plan bomb this shithole to hell was a go. We had to get out of there.
Oh, okay, it's time to leave now, is it? Thank God for that. Oh, now you want to run. Glad your equipment works. Oh, it's in movie mode now. That's great. Yeah, man, it's time to leave, blood!
We lost Taylor, but we had a lead. Moretti said Bishop could help us find Deimos, which meant he was our next stop.
This Bishop that Moretti mentioned?
Damian Bishop. The man who found the cure. A vaccination to make 6115 victims human again.
A cure? Did it work?
It should have. Something was blocking it. Bishop had this theory. He believed somewhere there was an undead brain. A single creature controlling them as a collective hive. He believed that it somehow blocked the cure. We met him in 2065 when he made the breakthrough. News traveled fast. He and a few others were kidnapped in Ethiopia. It was a joint op with Taylor's team. We were to extract Bishop from a base overrun by the dead. With the dead crawling all over, we needed a distraction. Something to keep the flesh eaters occupied so we could grab Bishop. We weren't dead killers yet, so we had to be a little more creative. And lucky for us, there were plenty of NRC birds in the sky, and the NRC's dead system still worked. Laser cannons built to auto-target any hostile aircraft.
So you created the diversion.
And Taylor's team prepped extraction. Unfortunately, it seemed our cover wouldn't last as long as we hoped. The remaining NRC noticed the radio silence from air traffic control and had sent soldiers to investigate. Command set exfil for a satellite station off base. We reset the dead system to target one of the automated planes circling above. Turns out the undead have a thing for giant explosions, like moths drawn to a porch lamp. And all we had to do was turn on the lights.
Yeah, we,
Unfortunately, we couldn't exactly control the landing. Hendrix alerted Taylor the bird was down and the diversion in play. We took out the NRC and moved. Bishop was being held underground in the security station across the tarmac.
The fuck is the way out of this show? Come on then. Come on in!
Hendrix ordered weapons down. The base was crawling with NRC soldiers and undead. No need to draw any more attention to ourselves. We crossed the tarmac. The tunnel ahead led to the security station.
Well, I just walked up behind him. Come on, mate. You want to go any fucking slower? Oh, I'm just going to walk through here today, ain't I? Yep, let's just putter through here and just, like, pretend nothing is happening.
Hendricks took out the guards. I hacked into the system to find Bishop.
Why were the NRC still at the base? It was being overrun.
They needed the cure. They kidnapped Bishop's whole team and would do whatever it took to get their hands on it. They'd torture these researchers till the dead broke down the door and ripped them all to shreds if it meant they could save their people. It wasn't personal. It was self-preservation. With the secret out about Bishop's discovery, he'd become the most wanted man in the world. The NRC were just the first to grab him. It was every country for itself. Why do you think we were there? The Winslow Accord wanted the same thing the NRC did.
You can't rationalize anything when you're put up against the wall.
Nothing about this was rational. It was instinctual, animalistic, survival. He had been escorted to an interrogation room. We had to hurry. Behind us was an undead army. Once one got a whiff, the others would come running.
Come on, then. It's the slowest part of the game. Wow, it's like World War III down here. Any more? Guess not. I like this gun. This is a good little gun.
Hendricks told Bishop who we were and that we had to move, but Bishop refused to leave without the other researchers, his friends. Our instructions were specific. Bishop was our priority. We didn't like it, but Bishop refused to leave without them.
It sounds like you were taking an awful risk.
He said for the cure to work, he needed them. They weren't expendable. Technically, we were.
In a way, you and the NRC were not so different in what you wanted and how far you were willing to go.
Our method was different. Our reasoning was not. No one wants to sacrifice themselves to save the world. But you like to think if the moment came, you'd have it in you.
Who was inside the cell?
Lieutenant Zied Khalil, member of the Egyptian army. Back in 65, he was a guard assigned to Bishop's research station. This was how we met. Hendricks cut him down and notified Taylor we were freeing the other hostages. Taylor said we didn't have the time. The base was swarming with additional NRC forces. They weren't letting their prize go that easily. There was a tunnel full of hostile soldiers between us and our exit. A cargo elevator ahead was the only way to the surface. No telling how close the dead were behind us.
No, they're in front of me. Oh, we are out of here now.
The remaining NRC forces were waiting for us above. They weren't about to let their prize prisoner go. If it meant getting the cure and saving their families, they were willing to die for it. And they weren't the only ones. We'd never seen dead killers in action before. To us, it was a spectacle. To them, it was just another day in the life. Wait a minute.
Do not be deceived by his lies. Remember your past. Remember when you first met John Taylor. Remember the truth.
Wait, this is wrong. This can't be real. I told you I met Taylor in Zurich during the 2065 Cathartist uprising, after I became a dead killer. But here I am with Taylor. And my limbs haven't been replaced yet. I'm still human. Why did you tell me that the first time I met Taylor was Zurich?
Focus. You need to complete this memory. What was Taylor's plan?
We were still on for Exfil. But first, we had to blow the bridge. We followed Diaz. Both undead and NRC forces were converging on our position.
No, not Sam. Naughty. Oh my God. Oh my God, it's like World War III in here. I say, I really do need that ammo box.
Hall grabbed us after the hangar. She was to take us to Moretti, so we could blow the bridge.
I have no idea what just happened there, but it didn't look good. This can't be good. If we had to destroy the bridge.
After the bridge, we were forced inside a comm center. Moretti took point. The rendezvous with Taylor was an APC garage just ahead.
Fuck, are we going now? Ow. Well, that was an easy one to kill.
Hear the undead screaming towards us. But that wasn't all. A robot horde was moving in. Taylor would need some time to get the door.
Wow, my controller's dying. Oh, I didn't need that much time.
Forced into the garage. What happened there?
Hendricks wanted to go back and get the other hostages. Taylor said Bishop was priority. After all, he had the cure. The rest were just lateral.
What did Taylor do?
Collectible discovery.
He volunteered to take his team to get the others. We were to take Khalil and Bishop to Exfil. We got on the APC. Bishop was the most important man in the world right now. We had to get him to Exfil if it killed us.
It's just not over yet. Oh my God. It's just the way out of this dice, man.
We came in too fast. The APC spun out and crashed. Hendrix moved Bishop into position. The drone evac was inbound. Once secured in the drop pod, it would return to collect. We just needed to hold back the Horde.
Let me on there, come on.
What happened?
Airspace was compromised. They had to pull out. Bishop was priority. We were extended. We heard Taylor with bombs. He was inbound and told us to hang on. No. I can't do this. I can't live this again. No. Please.
I am sorry. You must...
No, please!
If you wish to defeat Deimos, you must. To save the world, you must relive this.
I should have died. I felt myself fade. It was over. That was the day I met John Taylor. That was the day I became a dead killer.
Is it? Wow.
That was the day you met Bishop, the man who found the cure. before he died at the Cairo Aquifers. Moretti told you to find him.
On Moretti's instruction, we sought him out. We told him what we knew, which at the time was just a name, Deimos. He didn't know much, just that Deimos was responsible for the outbreak, and that a safe house in Singapore had a dossier on the guy. So we returned to Singapore. Little did we know, Go Julan had taken the city, and somehow gotten the undead to obey her. If we were going to get to the safe house, we'd have to go through them. The vultures. Sadistic scavengers, ravaged by atrocity and time, driven by fear and insanity. We saw their victims strung up on display the moment we arrived.
When forced against the wall, the impurities of man can be revealed.
It was more than that. This was survivalism. When only 1% of the world's population is human, you either died and became the undead, or you survived by preying on the living.